Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I would like to read the resolution of Australian Hazaras on the genocide of Hazaras in Pakistan. We, the Hazara people of Australia, strongly and loudly ask the Australian government, the UN, and the government of Pakistan to prevent the genocide in making of our people in Pakistan. The definition of genocide, according to both the Convention on the Prevention and Punishment of the Crime of Genocide, Article 3, and the Rome Statutes of the International Criminal Court, Article 6, is any act committed with the intention to destroy in whole or in part a national, ethnic, racial, or religious group. This could be any act such as killing, causing serious bodily or mental harm, inflicting conditions to bring about physical destruction in whole or in part. There are about 600,000 Hazaras in Pakistan who are living through an ethnic cleansing carried out by the state-supported terrorists and extremist organizations. The history of Hazaras in Pakistan goes back to late 19th century, when more than half of the population of Hazaras was massacred in Afghanistan, and a great number of them were forced to banish their homes and take refuge in the neighboring countries. These waves of mass migration into neighboring countries have continued until today. The recent one started when Taliban took power in Afghanistan. Even though the collapse of Taliban regime in Afghanistan by the allied forces encouraged many Hazaras in Iran and Pakistan to return to their homes, the regular nomadic attacks on Hazaras and the oppressive treatment by the current government is once again driving Hazaras to flee the country. This time, however, the neighboring countries are no more welcoming to Hazaras. Only in the last few years, about 700 Hazaras have been killed and over 1,000 permanently incapacitated in the Quetta city of Pakistan. These killings are carried out by RPG firings on residential areas and suicide attacks and machine gun firings at civilians during normal daily activities and communal festivities. Target killing of Hazaras has become a daily norm in Pakistan, which, if not prevented early on, will become a wide-scale genocide. These killings are carried out following regular religious decrees that identify Shia Hazaras as infidels who must be killed. An open letter which was published in Daily Jang, one of the leading national newspapers of Pakistan, called for killing Hazaras on the spot wherever they were found in order to clean the pure land of Pakistan from these infidels. Such open letters contain the signatures of prominent religious scholars, which make them very effective in manipulating the public opinion. The government of Pakistan is complicit in supporting the terrorist organizations that carry these systematic attacks. The offshoots and proxies of Al-Qaeda and Taliban take pride in having devastated the Hazaras communities and crushed their social life in Afghanistan, and they now intend to do the same in Pakistan. These are the aims they explicitly state in their open letters and their religious teachings. We have played a significant role in the history and cultures of Afghanistan and Pakistan. The destroyed statues of Buddhas in Afghanistan were our historical pride. Dozens of social, academic, artistic, and sport figures and top army officers and commanders in Pakistan and Afghanistan are marks of the resilient and hardworking spirit of our people. Our people are eager to contribute to the development of just and peaceful society as a home for everyone. We have suffered from tyrannic oppression for over two centuries, and yet there is another Holocaust we have to go through in Pakistan. We, the Australian Hazara, strongly sympathize with the oppressed and tormented Hazaras who are suffering at the hands of Al-Qaeda and its proxies such as Lashkar-e-Jangvi in Pakistan. The crime of genocide is a justiciable offense under the Rome Statutes of the International Criminal Court. We believe that the international community, the United Nations, and particularly the Australian government have an obligation to prevent the genocide of Hazaras in Pakistan. Following the ratification of the Convention for the Prevention and Punishment of the Crime of Genocide. Pursuant to Article 8 of the Convention, which says any contracting parties may call upon the competent organs of the United Nations to take such action under the Charter of United Nations as they consider appropriate for the prevention and suppression of acts of genocide or any of the other acts enumerated in Article 3.